know. What do you think makes a good ball player?
I don't know.
You don't know?
This is the draft report on you. Basically, it goes poor build, skinny, lacks great physical stature and strength.
Lacks mobility and ability to avoid the rush. Lacks a really strong arm. Can't drive the ball downfield. Does not throw a really tight spiral.
System type player who can get exposed if forced to ad lib.
And gets knocked down easily.
That kind of gets me fired up because I'm thinking, you know, what the hell do these people know? I mean, that sounds like Joe Montana.
The combine, when you watch Tom, you saw this tall, gangly looking kid. Looked like having ever seen a weight room. Ran a 5'2 something. One of the slowest quarterbacks in the combine. Does he wow you throwing the ball? Mm-mm. There were some other guys that could shoot it. And he had just an okay arm. Did his coaches at Michigan really stand on the table and say, this is the greatest thing since Joe Montana? No, not even close. They had to decide if it was he or Drew Henson.
A coach or a scout tells you that this guy has the intangibles, or we're looking for the intangibles. That's a euphemism for saying we have no clue what we're looking for. We just know it when we see it.
Tom Brady wasn't something that happens every year. You're not going to find that sixth-round quarterback who becomes a Hall of Famer. It just isn't going to happen.
I never played football until my freshman year, and as a freshman, I was the backup quarterback on a team that was 0-8.
The team didn't score a touchdown, and he wasn't deemed good enough to play one offensive play as a quarterback.
The only reason why I played my sophomore year was because the kid who was the freshman quarterback stopped playing because I'm not playing football anymore. So I was like, I guess I'm going to play. And I always had a decent arm, but I just really took to the game.
And with the 199th overall pick, they selected a skinny quarterback from Michigan named Tom Brady.
There's nothing we could really do about the whole Henson situation. We just had to evaluate what we saw. And we saw Tom time and again his senior year start the game off well, and then so many times Tom would come back in and rescue the situation and pull out the win for Michigan against great competition, the biggest game. He just took his opportunities and tried to make the most out of them.
Brady made his share of rookie mistakes.
I can't stand it. Run it again. Huddle up and run it again, Brady.
But he possessed a veteran's confidence.
This skinny beanpole of a young man walked over to me and said, "Hi, Mr. Kraft, I want to introduce myself. I'm Tom Brady." I said, "I know who you are. You're our sixth-round draft choice." And I always remember he looked me like a laser, eye to eye, and he said, "That's right, and I'm the best decision this organization has ever made."
The 2001 season was barely underway when Drew Bledsoe suffered internal injuries from a brutal hit by Mo Lewis.
Did you realize when you got hit how serious that was?
No, I couldn't think straight then. I had a, on top of the internal thing, I also got my bell rung pretty good.
If I was in that situation, I don't know how I could have dealt with it. You know, when you're the quarterback, you always feel like, I've had a big part to do with this game. When you're the backup quarterback, you don't even feel like you're on the team. You feel like you're a fan. You know, like, God, I didn't do anything to help our team win. You always feel that I'm just taking up space.
Brady calling signals. The direct snap to Brady. Standing in there. Looks to the left, loses the football. It's on the ground. And let's see if it's a fumble or a pass attempt. I believe it's going to be called a fumble. It is.
This will decide the football game.
Roy Coleman. The quarterback's arm is going forward.
Mama told me, go make yourself some friends or you'll be lonely. Once I was 7 years old.
Coming up, it's Super Bowl 36 from New Orleans between the Rams and the Patriots.
It was a big, big world, but we thought we were bigger. Pushing each other
Brady
to
back.
The limits, we
Five
were learning quicker.
Touchdown!
By 11, smoking bird and drinking bourbon liquor. Never been so eager, out to make that steady bigger. Once I was
right
11 years old,
now with no timeout, you haven't played for overtime.
Get yourself on the field,
you know,
once I was 11 years old.
Gets the first down.
Brady again. Out the middle, Cobb. And it's Thorne Brandon, and he gets out of 7 seconds. They got Vinatieri in range. And it's right down the pipe.
Something about that glory just always seem to bore me. Cause only those I really love will ever really know me. Once I was 20 years old, my story got told. Before the morning sun when life was lonely. Once I was 20 years old. I only see my hopes. I don't believe in failure. Cause I know the smallest voices, they can make it major. I got my boys with me. Traveled around the world and we're still roaming. Soon we'll be 30 years old.
The New England Patriots claim their second Super Bowl championship.
I'm still learning about life. My woman brought children for me, so I can sing them all my songs and I can tell them stories. Most of my boys are with me. Some are still out seeking glory, and some I had to leave behind. My brother, I'm still savvy. Soon I'll be 60 years old. My daddy got 61, remember life, and then your life becomes a better one. I made a man so happy when I rode the leather once. I hope my children come and visit once or twice a month. Soon I'll be 60 years old. Will I think the world is cold? Or will I have a lot of children who can bore me? Soon I'll be 60 years old. Mama told me, go make yourself some friends or you'll be lonely. Once I was 7 years old.
Intercepted. The Patriots are going to be Super Bowl champions again.
It was a great moment to be able to just, you know, hug Charlie and Romeo there at the end.
I put him as the best of all time.
Tom Brady.
Tom Brady.
Tom Brady.
Tom Brady is chasing history.
The New England Patriots one win away from the second perfect season in NFL history. Brady throws, Moss, touchdown! Corey Webster was in trouble as soon as he started backpedaling off the line of scrimmage. They doubled Wes Welker on the inside, and they left Corey Webster one-on-one on Randy Moss. And it just wasn't a match. 32. Good snap, good hold, and a good kick.
Nobody ever sees. I left my soul.
Touchdown, New England.
Back then, oh, I'm too weak. Most nights I pray for you to come home.
By Lawrence Maroney.
Praying to the Lord. Praying for my soul.
Pressure from Thomas off the edge. Eli Manning stays on his feet. Airs it out down the
most
field.
Most nights I hardly sleep when I'm alone.
Oh, my
now
God. This ball's thrown, and Tyree just goes up for it like a basketball player. Harrison trying to knock
I
it down.
You
and Eli, man, I don't know how he got out of there. I thought he was on the ground.
Please don't
and then he came out of the pile and just swings it. That's a great catch by David Tyree. Now with 59 seconds left,
I don't ever wanna know.
The Giants needing a touchdown.
Don't ever want to see things change. Cause when I'm living on my own, I want to take it back and start it again. Most nights I pray for you to come home.
Great job. Ellis Hobbs in coverage. He starts to the inside just enough to sell the slant. And then he goes to the corner, and it worked beautifully. Eli Manning puts a little pump fake on him to get him to bite, and then goes to the corner. The Giants have won the Super Bowl. It will go down as one of the biggest upsets in Super Bowl history. The Giants win.
Gronkowski had the last chance to try and get it. But the New York Giants, the 9-win NFC East winning New York Giants, for the second time in 4 years, go on an unexpected run for the ages and knock off the New England Patriots in the Super Bowl. The Giant family is excited. Peyton Manning is excited. Tom Coughlin has two Super Bowl rings, only one fewer than the man who embraced him after the game. Bill Belichick and the Patriots watch Eli Manning
hoist in the opening quarter. Stephen Ridley, who might not see any more playing time in 2013, coughs it up for the third straight game.
No, he won't. Isn't he 4-10 now?
Huh? Coming in. Okay. Coming in. So 4-10. Von Miller, 60 yards for the touch.
Coming in 4-9. So right now 4-10.
Yeah, why do we just say 4-10? I said coming in.
But why not just say 4-10?
Pay attention. I'm behind in the highlight already.
My fault.
Next possession, Brady.
I'm sorry.
Stripped and fumbled. Once turned.
They hit that blunt.
No, who hit that blunt?
Somebody hit that blunt hard.
Yeah. Me and Nacho hit that blunt. Recovered by Danny Trevathan. We're going the other way, but he was actually down by contact. Second quarter, same score. Peyton Manning, no Julius Thomas, inactive because of an injury. Jacob Tammy.
Made good ball today. Jacob Tammy stood in and made some
plays. Second and two. And there is no challenge. And now it's first down and goal from the 5-yard line. Brady will throw it, and Edelman is there and pulls it in for the touchdown. Manning sets up the screen, and Ball will lose the ball. And the Patriots are all over it, but the ball is still loose. And at the end of the day, who's got it? The Patriots had about four chances to come up with the ball. Of course, Thomas signals one way. The Patriots signal the other way. New England
about on it. So here we go. We get, okay, this Dave Fletcher coming here and kind of big.
And Devlin has the fullback.
This is brilliant stuff this man does.
but you wanna say no. What do you mean? When you don't want me to move, but you tell me to go. What do you? Oh, what do you? Since you're running out of time, what do you? Better make up your mind. What do you? What do you make up your mind? What do you?
Tonight, the New England Patriots are fighting back against accusations of unsportsmanlike conduct. Did they deflate footballs during their championship game to gain a strategic advantage? With their coach coming under fire again?
It's the latest NFL scandal, and it's dominating the airwaves.
Deflategate.
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 From the morning shows to talk radio, instead of talking about the Super Bowl, all eyes are on the ball. This ball.
News overnight, the so-called Deflategate. NFL sources revealing to ESPN that the Patriots did use underinflated football.
As he turns 35, Tom Brady's on the downside of his career. And if you ask me if he'll ever get to another Super Bowl, I have one answer. No way, no how.
Brady will go from being elite, maybe he's still the best, to can no longer play effectively in the NFL. It's going to happen in an eye blink.
So a weak team, the New England Patriots, let's face it, they're not good anymore.
Tom Brady is just about done. It could be his next game he plays, it could be a year from now, but he is going to fall off a cliff. Tom Brady is going to be a bum in short order. Now,
bottom line is the fact that I realized that even the group of people I hung around with, you know, it was easy for me to think that I was doing a lot because I was doing more to try to move myself forward than they were. And I should be the weakest link in my chain that I have, and that'll make me be stronger, it'll make me run faster. I mean, like an analogy I've always used is, all right, if you run the 100-yard dash with people that can't run as fast as you, yeah, you'll win. Hands down, you know that. But if you run with people much faster than you, all right, yeah, you might come in last every single time, but your time will be better because they're making you run all the faster. They're making you dig down just a little bit more. Doesn't matter that you won, your time is faster.
You gotta have a vision for what it is you really, truly want. A vision is about what you're here to create. A vision that really works is one that excites you. It has to be a compelling vision. It's got to have something that has the power to pull you, not something you have to push yourself to do. Those are two different kinds of motivation. Push requires willpower, and willpower never lasts. What will last is pull. Having something so exciting, so attractive, so something you desire so much that you have a hard time going to sleep at night, and you get so up early in the morning to rock it and take it to the next level.
Now, what do you do during the hard times, Les? Here's what you must do. Number one is, you must have faith. Paul said you must have the faith to call forth those things that be not as though they were. Judge not according to appearances. Don't judge your circumstances, and the possibilities for your future based upon what you have now and because of what's going on now. No. That's not the real reality there. What you're going through, if you're going through some hard times, it has not come to stay. It has come to pass. No matter how bad it is or how bad it gets, I'm going to make it. As I used to say to myself, when I would get up in the Penobscot building and I had to go into the bathroom and bathe in the bathroom sink, I have written on the mirror that I put up, it just pasted up and I read, no matter how bad it is or how bad it gets, I'm going to make it. So you've got to have faith, you talk to yourself, you say that affirmation. The next step is you must have patience and engage in consistent action.
Get back up. Some things you can't change. You just have to live with. But if you do have a choice, make the right choice. When it hurts, keep going. Those cloudy days, those storms, telling you to keep going. Get back up.
Way o'er the land. up the champagne. Pop. It's my house, come on, turn it up. Hear a knock on the door and the night begins. Cause we've done this before, so you come on in. Make yourself at my home, tell me where you been. Pour yourself something cold, baby, cheers to this. Sometimes you gotta stay in, and you know where I live. Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay in, and welcome to my house. Baby, take control now. We can't even slow down. We don't have to go out. Welcome to my house. And you know that you wanna stay. Close the blinds, let's pretend that the time has changed. Keep our clothes on the floor, open up champagne. Let's continue tonight, come on, celebrate.
That's how we do.
Sometimes you gotta stay in, and you know where I live. Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay in. Welcome to my house, baby, take control now. We can't even slow down, we don't have to go out. Welcome to my house, play that music too loud. Show me what you do now, we don't have to go out. Welcome to my house.
Shot of vodka, you know what's in my glass. It's my house, just relax.
Welcome to my house, baby, take control now. We can't even slow
hit the brakes,
down.
Hit the brakes,
we don't
slow
have to go.
Cheers to this.
Welcome to my house. Play that music too loud. Show me what you do now. We don't have to go out. Welcome to my house.
As he turns 35, Tom Brady's on the downside of his career. And if you ask me if he'll ever get to another Super Bowl, I have one answer. No way, no how.
Tom Brady's just about done. It could be his next game he plays. It could be a year from now. But he is going to fall off a cliff. Tom Brady is going to be a bum in short order. Now, happen, Brady will go from being elite, maybe he's still the best, to can no longer play effectively in the NFL. It's going to happen in an eye blink.
We saw a weak team, the New England Patriots. Let's face it, they're not good anymore.
A direct snap, and it's good. James White.
Your little brother never tells you, but he loves you so. You said your mother only smiled on her TV show. You're only happy when your sorry head is filled with dope. I hope you make it to the day you're 28 years old. You're dripping like a saturated sunrise. You're spilling like an overflowing sink. You ripped at every edge, but you're a masterpiece. And now you're tearing through the pages and the ink. His hands, his jeans, and now I'm covered in the colors. Pull apart at the seams, and it's blue. And it's blue. Everything is gray. His hair, his smoke, his dreams. And now he's so deep, void of color. He don't know what it means. And he's blue. wings, and now I'm covered in the colors, pull apart at the seams, and it's blue.
The final in overtime, and the Patriots have redefined the word momentum here tonight.
In the greatest Super Bowl ever played, and you're the victor.
2 years ago, we won our fourth Super Bowl down in Arizona, and I told our fans that was the sweetest one of all. But a lot has transpired during the last 2 years. And I don't think that needs any explanation. But I want to say to our fans, our brilliant coaching staff, our amazing players who are so spectacular, this is unequivocally the sweetest. And I'm proud to say, for the fifth time, we are all Patriots, and tonight, for the fifth time, the Patriots are world champions.
Thank you, Mr. Kraft. Congratulations, sir. 5 out of 7, Bill Belichick, Coach Belichick. Hop over here on this side, Coach.
Well, there's so much debate about who's the greatest coach in the history of the NFL tonight that got solved. That would be you, my young man. Congratulations.
Thanks, Terry. But look, it's all about these players. We got great players. They're tough, and they compete. We thought they competed for 60 minutes, but it took more tonight. These guys competed,
down 28-3. They never look back.
That's what I was going to say. You went into halftime. This football game was pretty much getting out of control. Both of you tried. The opening drives didn't score. They go down and score. We got a 28-point game here, and it just looks like all the wind's out of your sail. How did this team come back?
They just keep competing. We got great players, and they just compete for 60 minutes or longer.
Coach, congratulations.
Thank
well
you,
deserved.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Pass.
Tom Brady. Well, I got the greatest coach in the NFL. Might as well have the greatest quarterback. Tom Brady. Oh, man. How good is this, boy? Huh? Here, let me hand it. No. Let me hand it to you. How sweet is that, Tom? The only four-time MVP, the only quarterback, the first quarterback to ever win five Super Bowls. This is not easy, Tom. Coming out in the second half, this just did not look like the same Patriot team we've seen all year. What turned it around? Was it the penalty, the holding call, the pass that was incomplete after the great catch by Jones? And all of a sudden, you go down and tie this thing up.
Well, there were a lot of plays that, Coach talks about. You never know which play it's going to be in the Super Bowl. And there was probably 30 of them tonight that if any one of those would have been different, the outcome could have been different. But I'm so proud of our guys, our coaches, the team. I mean, it's unbelievable, you know, what these guys have accomplished all season. I'm just proud to, you know, be a part of this great group.
Your father is here for the first time this year. Your mother, after an illness for 18 months, Galen, she's here tonight. You dedicated this game to her. She has got to be beyond herself right now.
Yeah, they're all happy. So it's nice to have everybody here, and it's going to be a great celebration tonight. So thank you to all our fans. Everyone back in Boston, New England, we love you. You've been with us all year. We're bringing this sucker